Marriage is both a very private and a very public act. Marriage is private because it involves the love and commitment between two individuals. Only these two who stand before us now will make a covenant with one another. They alone know in their hearts how they feel for one another, and they alone will make the decisions necessary to keep this love and marriage possible. Marriage is also a public act and a communal act. These two stand before friends, family, and God. Their decision to marry affects all who are present in many different ways. To some, it represents a public vow to behave in ways that indicate the uniqueness of this couple's relationship to one another. To others, it's the bringing together of families. To these, the caring and loving relationships of the past are not forgotten or should be. Rather, the present and the hope for the future is celebrated. The commitment to love and to care for one another is reaffirmed. Marriage was confirmed by... What I want you to do now is I want you to say your vows that you've written to one another.
Some people here today may already know this story, but after about 2 weeks of dating Dorothy, I told her that I loved her. Of course, this sent her into a panic, and rightfully so. I mean, 2 weeks? Come on, that's not how it works.
It's not normal.
After catching her panic vibes, I had to do something very uncomfortable. I had to tell her that I indeed did not love her. It was weird. We continued dating, and eventually, as we both felt it would, time would correct my mistake, and we would both say, I love you. Dorothy, I promise to be by your side through our toughest times and your most joyous moments. I promise to squeeze you when you feel anxious and to hold you when you are worrisome. I promise to learn from you day by day as you embody the soul of everything that is kind, loving, and patient. You are who I aspire to be like. I promise to thrive with you in our biggest moments and stop and cherish all the small ones we have along the way. I promise to work as a team through every obstacle we face and every hurdle we triumph. I promise to always dino stomp on autumn leaves and to continue replacing random song lyrics with our pets' names. And as we both age magnificently into our golden years, some of these promises may become harder to keep due to the physical nature of growing older. But there is one promise I can keep with 100% certainty throughout all of our years. I promise to never say I don't love you ever again.
Oh, that was so cute. Sorry. Okay, so here's what I think. You're my best friend. You're the best person I know that genuinely cares about everybody and has the kindest heart. You make me laugh even when I don't want to at all. You take care of me when I can't take care of myself. Even your flaws come from a good place. Like, they're never malicious. They're always, like, out of kindness from your heart. And that's my favorite. You're the best person I know. Promises to say thank you more and make you feel appreciated for all that you do for me. Let you cuddle me in the middle of the night, potentially, even when I have work the next day. To let the little things go more, to help cook more often and not just drink wine in the corner. To actually laugh at your jokes when I really want to deep down, but for some reason I don't let myself, which is stupid, because I love to laugh with you. To support you in whatever you do, no matter what it is, because I know we can make it together, no matter what. To avoid the dollar section of Target, except for, it's hard, for except for once or twice a month. To rub your back whenever you're scared, and to make you feel loved and safe for eternity.
As a token and a pledge.
As a token and a pledge.
That I will perform my holy vows.
That I will perform my holy vows.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
As a token and a pledge.
As a token and a pledge.
That I will perform my holy vows.
That I will perform my holy vows.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
By joining hands, I declare you, husband and wife, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now, may the bride kiss the groom. I present to you now Mr. and Mrs. Kyle Pennington.
Dorothy, Kyle, it's been a joy and a ride being y'all's friend for this long, and just want to thank you guys for teaching me that friendship is really the foundation of true love. So, to Kyle and Dorothy.
And everything is going to the beat.